Male and female bodies, which look quite similar when we're born, develop a number of physical attributes that easily differentiate them over time. These can develop at different rates and in a wide variety of sizes, shapes, and levels of prominence. You've likely noticed by now that almost all of our body parts have names that somehow sound biological. Brain, heart, lungs, stomach, kidneys, legs, arms, and all the rest. For that reason, the name Adam's apple definitely stands out, and not just from your neck. So, what's with the weird name? Well, as you may have guessed, the Adam's apple does have to do with someone named Adam. According to religious folklore, Adam, the first human in the creation myth of the Abrahamic religions, lodged a piece of apple, the forbidden fruit, in his throat. All men, who are believed to be the descendants of Adam and Eve, have that same lump in their throat as evidence of that biblical event. However, in reality, the appearance of a prominent Adam's apple has a lot more to do with the larynx and thyroid cartilage. The larynx is an organ in the neck of mammals and certain other organisms that facilitates breathing, protects the trachea against food aspiration, and plays a critical role in sound production. Due to the last of those reasons, it's also commonly referred to as the voice box. On the surface of the larynx, there are six sections of cartilage that provide structural support to the larynx and make up the laryngeal skeleton, which is basically a skeleton around the larynx. Out of the unpaired cartilages in the body, the thyroid cartilage is the largest and is directly responsible for the presence of the Adam's apple. Both boys and girls are born with larynxes, but when boys hit puberty, their voice box grows in size significantly more than it grows in girls, as their testosterone levels increase. This results in the cracking of boys' voices, as well as a more prominent Adam's apple in that gender. That said, women can have an Adam's apple too. Both boys and girls are born with an Adam's apple. It's simply not as noticeable in most women. There may be a number of reasons for this, such as a genetic trait or an anatomical anomaly. Or it could not be an Adam's apple at all, but rather a physical growth on the neck due to some other medical condition. Unfortunately, the presence of an Adam's apple in women is sometimes considered unwomanly, as it's commonly identified as a characteristic feature of adult men. This could potentially affect their sense of feminism in a negative way or threaten their self-confidence. As a result of this unfair treatment, some people choose to undergo surgery to have the size of their Adam's apple reduced in a procedure called a chondrolaryngeoplasty, which, like all surgeries, has some potential risks associated with it. Counseling can and does help women deal with this uncomfortable situation psychologically without invasive surgery, and is therefore highly recommended.